So now we will see the second kind of machine, that is your pulley. Already you have discussed the levers, pulley. You know also these things, pulley. That pulley is a what? It's a wooden or metallic ring with a grooved rim, and a string is passed around it. A rope or string is passed around it, and you have seen that the well. In the when you are using the tube, you want to pull out a bucket full of water from well. If pulley is there, you are giving the force in the downward direction, and the bucket full of water is moving in the upward direction. You have seen the pulley, and we'll see the single fixed pulley. What is single fixed pulley? If the axis of rotation is fixed, it's one direction, that is a single fixed pulley. Suppose this is your what? Pulley and string, this is a support. So suppose this one is your load, okay, and this one, if this side you will give effort in this direction, then the load will up in the upward direction. Effort is in this direction, the load will up in this direction. And this is your C load. Generally in the string case, one tension force is acting. If any point we want to find the tension, and that from away from that point always tension is acting. Suppose at this point if I want to find the tension, then the tension is in this direction. Suppose at this point, the string point, I want to find tension, then this away from the point, this is your tension direction. Suppose this is your effort, you are giving the effort in this direction. In this point you want to find the tension, it is in the upward direction. For at this first string, you want to find at this point the string tension direction, it is from the away. That means in this direction the tension will act. So now you see, tension is also one kind of force. So now you see, this is your what? Load, and this direction tension is acting. So L equals to T. Effort is in this direction, T is in this direction, so the effort is equals to T. So L equals to T, E is equals to T. So now you see, what is mechanical advantage? Mechanical advantage is equals to load by effort, that is your T by T, that is equals to what? 1. So mechanical advantage is 1, and this mechanical advantage is 1 for ideal case, not for practical case. If we will consider the mass, string is having no mass, massless string. If there is a no friction between this pulley and this there is no friction between this string and this rim with the group rim. So in that case, we can say that only the mechanical advantage is equals to 1 for ideal case. Okay, but for velocity ratio, for single fixed pulley, it is fixed. That is, velocity ratio is 1. It is fixed. But mechanical advantage is not equals to 1. It is 1 for ideal case. You know, you see, for if mechanical advantage is equals to 1, that means it is not a force multiplier. It is not a speed multiplier. That means, what is the function of single fixed pulley? It only changes the direction. Yes, it is changes the direction. If effort is in this downward direction, the load is in the upward direction. It only function is, it only changes the direction. It is not used as a force multiplier. It is not used as a speed multiplier. One more question is there. Why, if mechanical advantage, why it is not equals to 1 for ideal case, means for practical case? Because there is some loss of energy due to the frictions between the strings and this rim system. And if the string is having some mass, okay. So this is about your single fixed pulley. Now you see, single movable pulley whose axis of rotation is not fixed, whose axis of rotation is movable, that is your what? Single movable pulley. So this is your what? Attach point. This is your one pulley I have taken here. This is your what? Load. You want to lift this load in the upward direction. If you will give effort in this direction, this load will move in the upward direction. Then how in this case we will find the mechanical advantage? Mechanical advantage is what? Load by effort. So how much load is, you see, this for this one is T and this one is T. The total upward force is a T plus T. 2t, and downward force is your what? L. So L by L equals to, for equilibrium position, the upward force equals to downward force. So the L is equals to 2t, and effort equals to t. So mechanical advantage is equals to 2t by t, that is your 2. So here mechanical advantage is 2, that means it is greater than 1. So it used as a force multiplier. Agar effort mein thoda sa bhi force hoga, it can move a lift a heavy load. And for single movable pulley, the velocity ratio is fixed. We will find this derivation, how velocity ratio is equals to 2. So velocity ratio is 2. And if velocity ratio is 2, it is greater than 1, but if the velocity ratio is greater than 1, its speed decreases, it not used as a speed multiplier. Okay, so how you see, actually the velocity ratio is 2. So you see, first suppose if you want to lift this load, suppose you means pull this effort in this direction, suppose this one move distance x, so this one is also move distance x. So velocity of effort is this direction x, this direction x. So this is your what? 2x. But load is 1 is your what? X. So velocity ratio is a 2x by x, that is equals to 2. So velocity ratio is fixed for single movable pulley. But mechanical advantage is 2 only for the ideal case. When there is no loss of energy, there is no friction. Okay students, we have already discussed the single fixed pulley, single movable pulley, and this is your pulley 3, type 3. This is your block and tackle system. In block and tackle system, we are using the number of pulleys, and also we can categorize it into a combination of pulley. The single movable pulley also, that one is also a one combination of pulley. One fixed pulley is there, one movable pulley is there. And here in block and tackle system, you see in block and tackle system, generally the number of pulleys are used, and here two part is there, two blocks are there. The upper part is upper part is connected to the support, rigid support, and the lower part is connected to the load. Okay, and that upper part is known as block and the lower part is known as tackle. Generally the upper part is what? Fixed, and the lower part is movable. So that's why this is known as the combination of pulley or the block and tackle system. Okay, generally actually in your book it is written that upper part which is fixed and the lower part which is movable. But some books it is written that these three pulleys are only the blocks and on the strings are only the movable. Okay, that one is tackle. But according to your class, this is your block and this one is your tackle. And remember one thing. In the block and tackle system, the upper part, in the upper part, the number of pulleys always greater than the number of pulleys in the lower part. For example, suppose three pulleys are there, in upper part 2 and the lower part is 1. Suppose if four pulleys are there, then upper part 2, lower part is 2. Either it is equal, block and tackle is equal, or the upper part is always greater than the lower part. So you just see, this is the combination of three pulley. Here only in your book it is, in your syllabus only it is there. So suppose mechanical advantage is 3, it is given, or velocity ratio is 3, you have to draw the combination of pulley. Then 3 mechanical advantage is 3, that means here number of pulley is 3. So the upper part 2 and the lower part 1. And the lower part, you just connect one load and one string is like this. You just see here like this, and here. Okay, so you just see effort, this one is tensor, and for this pulley, this is your T, this is your T, for this point, this is your T. I had told that for pulley system, always the tension is away from the point. So this is your tension, this is your tension, and this is your tensor. So the lower part, the load, total load is T plus T plus T, that is your what? 3T, and the effort is T, T is equals to T. The mechanical advantage is what? Load by effort, 3T by 3. That is your mechanical advantage is 3. So that means it used as a force multiplier. And here velocity ratio is also 3. And for ideal case, actually we are considering everything the ideal case. You are neglecting the mass of the string, frictions. So the mechanical advantage is here 3 and the velocity ratio is 3. Now you see here, I have taken here 4 pulley system. So 4 pulley, you can 4 pulley, that means you can take here that number of pulleys here 2 or upper part 3, down part 1. So I have taken here 2, here 2, here 2. Okay, so this one you see the string, how it is attaching, so like this. So this is your T for this pulley, the tension is T away from the point, T, and for this one, this is your T and this is your T. So this one is a load is connected to the lower part. So lower part, how many T's are there? T plus T plus T plus T. So load is 4T and effort is T. So T cancel, mechanical advantage is 4, velocity ratio is 4. Next you see pulleys of 5 number of pulleys are there. So 5 number of pulleys are there. I had told always the upper part, the number of pulley is 4. So I have connected here 3 pulleys. 1, 2, 3. Upper part 3 pulleys. Down part 2 pulleys. So you see the strings are how it is attaching. Like this. So here T, T, 1 T, 1 T, 1 T. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see, I am considering the T for the lower part only, for this lower part. So L is equals to what? 5T, and the effort is T. So mechanical advantage is 5T by T, that is here 5. Mechanical advantage is 5. And from these 3 we conclude that, so always L is equals to L into T. L is your what? The number of pulleys. Total system, how many numbers of pulleys are there? You see here, how many pulleys are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So L equals to 5. So L equals to 5T. And effort is T. So mechanical advantage is L. If in a system 5 number of pulleys are there, then mechanical advantage is 5. If in a system the 4 number of pulleys are there, then mechanical advantage is 4. So that's why I have written here mechanical advantage is equals to L. That is the total number of pulley. On the basis of this, so many questions are there in your book. Mechanical advantage is given. Or velocity ratio, if mechanical advantage is given 4, then you can draw the 4 pulleys 2 and 2. And if velocity ratio is given and efficiency is given, I have told one formula, that is the mechanical advantage is equals to MA equals to efficiency into velocity ratio. So by calculating the mechanical advantage, you can draw the block and tackle system of pulley. So this completes your block and tackle system. You will do the numericals.